Welcome back to the Big Joe Henry Variety Show. You having a good time? Oh, you're gonna have a better time right now. We're having so much fun. I'm so glad he's here. Ladies and gentlemen, our next guest is a terrific TV actor. He's a comedian. He's been on the big screen TV commercials, including a great appearance on Boardwalk Empire. You've seen him all over the place. He's a champion of causes, and he's also an East Coast Black Belt champion, so don't mess with him. Ladies and gentlemen, a good friend of mine, he's New Jersey's own Jeff Norris.
Wow, Big Joe. Thank you, Joe.
Thank you, brother.
It's good to be here. How's everybody? I tell you, it's great to be in front of such a young-looking crowd. I just got off of a cruise ship performing, and I tell you, I enjoy working and performing for the elderly, but it got a little rough. Every time I put my drink down, somebody put their teeth in it. I mean, that's when you know you have it. But I got hit on. I got to tell you, 2 weeks at sea, everybody starts to look good. 85-year-old lady on a walker approached me in a casino, and she said, "Hey, hottie, how you like a little mother-daughter action?" So I walked back to her room, she opened the door, and she went, "Ma, wake up!" So that's when you know you gotta get home. I travel a lot. I fly out of Newark, New Jersey. Newark, I tell you, Newark is scary. I finally get on the plane, I brought something illegal on board. Soap and shampoo. I didn't know. The lady said, "Sir, I have to take that." I go, "It's shampoo." She says, "It's not regulation size. We only allow 3 fluid ounces of product. And that's a 44-ounce bottle of shampoo." I go, "I know, my wife shops at Costco. We got a lot of big things in the house. I don't like it either." You know, in a crazy world, I'm very proud to share something with you. I'm in what you call interracial marriage. And I do say it proudly, because it is kind of a racist world, and I married a woman outside of my race. I'm very proud of that. As you can tell, I'm Irish, and my wife is Italian. Now, take it easy. That's interracial. Put the gun back in your ankle, Tony. Relax over there. I married one of you. As a matter of fact, if you're Italian, we're probably related and don't even know. Italian people have the biggest families. I get the bright idea to invite them all to my house to meet my parents out of respect, and plus I've seen Italian movies. I said, "Why don't you bring your family over?" She says, "My whole family?" I said, "Well, sure, 95 cars pull up." I opened the door, it was like a Verizon commercial. She was standing there, there's all these Italians behind her. "Hey, can you hear me freaking now, huh?" There's 120 Italians in my parents' living room. I start to panic. My parents are your typical Irish parents, you know? They're fantastic. My dad was my best man at my wedding, he's my best friend, you know? And I sat him down and I says, "Hey, you know, Renee's family's in the living room." He's thinking family like an Irish family. Mother, sister, father, brother, dog. That's it. He has no idea there's a union meeting going on in the living room. We all have people in our lives that remind us of celebrities. Now, my mom and dad are the modern-day version of Edie and Archie Bunker from All in the Family. My wife's family is the cast of Goodfellas, Casino, and Mob Wives, okay? So here comes my dad, drunk Archie Bunker, takes one look at everybody, he does this. "Whoa, geez, dear, would you look at this, huh?" "Whoa, geez, dear, how you eat it there, huh? You see what the heck your son brought home in the other room there? Oh, geez, help me out there, Lord. I got 120 Italians in my living room and no plastic on my sofas there." Now, my mother walks in. She's like Edith Bunker. I'm like, "Mom won't say anything wrong." Sure enough, she comes running out. She's like, "Oh, my God, how are? It's so nice to have all of yous in our home. Yeah. I haven't seen this many Italians in one room since I had jury duty." I'm like, "Oh, God, don't say that." Not a moment of truth for every guy when you're going to meet the father of the woman you're going to marry. For me, it was like meeting Robert De Niro on a bad day. He walked in the room, the house got cold. She goes, "Daddy, I want you to meet Jeff." He turned around, I got this. "Come here, you. Come here, you. Come here, you." He said everything 3 times, honest to God. He's like, "Excuse me, excuse me, excuse me." Which was ironic, the very next sentence, he goes, "I'm only gonna say this once. I'm only gonna say this once." So I thought I was done meeting everybody. I went, hey, it was so nice to meet everybody. Thank you for coming to my parents' house. I got an idea. Let's do something Italian now, huh? Let's go outside and cement the backyard, you know? Because they love concrete and tomatoes. They do, right? But every Italian family got the little angry guy, you know? This case, it's my brother-in-law. I didn't even see him. He's standing right next to me. He's this big. He's like the little Joe Pesci of the house. He goes, nice meeting everybody. From my knee, I hear this. Okay. What the heck? What am I, a mirage over here, you fat Irish jerk? I picked them up. I burped them. I had no idea what to do, right? So we finally move in with each other. Now, I would never disrespect a woman on or off stage, and I mean that from the heart. But ladies, quick question. How big does the purse have to be? For what reason? Are we bowling after the show? There's no need. My wife has a beanbag with handles on it. If we ever get in a car accident, I'm just going to jump in the purse. I am. Well, we saw the news. Your truck exploded. No, I jumped in the purse. We were fine. We all floated home on tampons. Everybody lived. My wife came with shoes, purses, and cats. Now, the cats came in the house after we got married. Otherwise, I wouldn't have said I do. I would have said I might. Two cats, I gotta tell you, they're unbelievable. They're like step cats now. And I tried to like them, but these cats are old, ladies. I mean, one got a colostomy bag. I mean, come on. The one cat has one eye and three whiskers. That's it. All day he's like this. I wanna go left. And the one cat has what you call smoker's meow. You ever hear that? Smoker's meow from 17 years of her father going, How you doing? Smokers me out. 3 o'clock in the morning, the house is quiet. You hear this.
Meow. Meow.
I don't know what the hell to do, you know? I run into the kitchen to grab the broom, right? I go into the bedroom. The two cats are on the bed, on my side of the bed, on my pillow. And I'm aggravated because it's 20 seconds of this stuff. Yeah, they're marking their turf. They're rubbing their backside on it, like... I'm like, that's where I put my nose, for God's sakes, right? Fellas, big tough guy, I go to grab the cat goes like this. And now I'm scared because I'm naked, you see? And they have nails, and this is no scratching post, you know what I'm saying? So I run to the kitchen to grab the broom. I throw the broom at the cat to get my pillow back. The cat runs up the drapes, into the ceiling. He's hiding in the planter box. Now, I can't see him, I can only hear him. And it's scary. It's not the cute, typical meow. No, he's up there doing noises like meow, meow, meow. I go, oh, he's calling all his friends or he's texting somebody. I have no idea. I can only see shadows and images. And it reminded me of one of my favorite movies, The Predator with Arnold Schwarzenegger. Remember, he couldn't see the creature, but he had to hunt it? That was me in my dining room. I was like this. You want to play Predator? 4:30 in the morning, I'm naked with a broom playing Predator with an 88-pound diabetic cat. It was like this. What the hell are you? Come on, I'm here. Come on, kill me, I'm here. Come on, do it now. My wife comes out, catches me naked with a broom. I just stayed in character. She goes, what are you doing? I just went, shh. Get down. Get down. Hey, God bless you and your family.
Jeff Norris.
It's my time for a little bit here. I appreciate it. A little fun.
Jeff Norris, ladies and gentlemen. There you go.